I deal with a lot of people around the country, and one of the things I've seen is a lack of engagement, people failing to engage. And I'm so glad to see everybody here today, because this is engagement. This is coming and supporting Vernon and his family. This is coming to support change and progress. And we need to have more of this, not less of this. Abandonment of the government, abandonment of the issues, makes them compound, reinforces the strength they have. We need to come and say, no, we're going to speak the peace. We're going to do exactly what Mike said, and be a part of change, and engage to have change occur. And so our voices, I've met some regulators in my life, and some of them are pretty good guys. And some guys just don't know. And when 1,000 people show up at a hearing and say, this is the way the facts are, and they bring the scientists and everybody together, and they engage, these administrators a lot of times listen, and they don't want to be unpopular. And we have in America a weakening dairy system where the fluid milk that's being produced, that's pasteurized, has a very weak market position. It's losing about 1 to 2% per year, regardless of how much promotion is being made. So against the backdrop of increasing raw milk sales and increasing enthusiasm for raw milk, we have a weakening pasteurized milk, fluid milk market. Not yogurt and cheeses, they're doing okay on the pasteurized side. But they've got their bacteria added back in, and they're fermented, so they're more digestible and less allergenic. Can't say it. Allergenic, that's the word. The problem with pasteurized milk is it's cold, completely dead, and it's very, very allergenic. If you were to go to the FDA website, put in the most allergenic food in America, number one is pasteurized milk. Raw milk is exactly the opposite. So there's dollar voting going on right now. People are simply choosing not to buy food pasteurized milk and leaving it for raw milk, no milk, or mostly almond milk. It's very interesting. And in California, the dairy industry is in such a poverty-stricken mess. If you ask a lot of dairymen, I know all my friends of dairymen I know, ask them, what's the future of dairymen like you? And they say, I'm going to plant almond trees. So we don't have a strong fight against us for the dairy industry. We have a strong fight against us from the processing industry, who's taking a terrible advantage of the dairymen, and the processors that stand with administration and the regulation and the FDA.